Direct from downtown Main Street, it's Disney's House of Mouse.
Who's that knocking at the House of Mouse? We're all knocking at the House of Mouse. So come on in, we're gonna shake the house. We're all rocking at the House of Mouse. We're having a ball in Rock of the Hall. So come on in,
to the House of Mouse.
Room here for everyone.
The gang's all here and we're hanging out.
All this fun makes you jump and shout. Hey, little girl, I wanna dance with you.
We'll find so many things to do.
So come on in, we're gonna shake the house. We're having a ball
at the House of Mouse.
And now, the mouse herd round the world. Mickey Mouse!
Hi, folks! Welcome to the show! And now it's time to say goodbye! See you real soon!
That show was shorter than us!
Oh, no. There's lots more show. It's just that Minnie and I, well, we're taking a little vacation. And until we get back, the show will be handled by our best pals, Donald and Daisy!
Can you believe it, Mickey? We're actually going on vacation!
Believe it! 2 tickets for a cruise to the island paradise of Wacky Wacky.
It's about time you two got a break.
You deserve it.
And don't worry about us.
Yeah, don't worry.
Mickey, what if something happens to the club?
Aw, you heard them. They said not to worry.
Look, we've already got the whole club under control. Horace?
Cartoons are ready to roll.
Go fish!
Tonight's special is... have a nice tri-dip with hollandaise sauce.
And Clarabelle has packed your bags.
Red bow, polka dot dress, yellow shoes. Red shorts, yellow shoes, white gloves. I know my classics.
Hot dog, we're ready to go.
I'm not ready to go.
Oh, gosh, Minnie, I gave them the spare keys.
And the deliveries are all scheduled.
All the bills are paid. They can handle it, Minnie. Let's go.
Now, what about the show? You did book some good acts. Of course. Donald took care of it. You didn't book Mr. Toad again, did you?
Well...
yeah, last time he crashed right through this... motorbike!
I'll make shoes out of you!
Don't worry, we can handle it! Mickey, maybe we shouldn't go.
No more motorbike.
Remember, Daisy, it's always good to have something around to take the air out of Mr. Toad's tires.
Hey, folks, we haven't left on our vacation yet, but that's not going to stop you from going round the world.
A century ago, before airplanes filled the air. I said before they filled the air, thank you. The world was a bigger place, especially for a mouse. Mickey Mouse was the caretaker of the Humbleton Orphanage.
Morning, Clarabelle. Looks like you have your hooves full. Hey! That looks pretty good.
Despite his steadfast efforts, the orphanage was in grave financial trouble.
Bills? 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 Oh, gosh. How are we ever going to pay them?
Say, what's this? Dear Mr. Mouse, congratulations. You have inherited a fortune. Junk mail.
Wait a minute. Let's see. To claim your inheritance, your presence is requested at the Reform Club at precisely 6:00. Greedily yours, Scrooge McDuck. Oh, no! I'm already late!
You're late.
Sorry. Do I still get my money?
We'll see, won't we? For as the executor of your great uncle's will, it is my responsibility to carry out his instructions and bequeath to you his fortune.
Oh boy, the orphanage is saved.
That is, only if I deem you to be a trustworthy, hard-working, and punctual member of society.
Gosh, pretty much everybody knows they can trust Mickey Mouse. And gee, Goofy and I have been working real hard running that orphanage.
And in regards to being punctual?
You mean, like not being late?
Yes. For example, arriving on time to important engagements such as this.
No, oh, for once, don't live up to your name, Scrooge, and give the lad his money.
Yes, the old boy's a fine chap.
I'll gladly give Mr. Mouse his money.
Gee, thanks.
As soon as he passes a small test to prove his punctuality.
Test? What kind of test?
Ah, how about going round the world in 80 days?
Around the world in 80 days?
But he'd have to catch every train.
Make every ship.
And never be late.
Not even once.
It's the perfect test. And you believe today, October 1st, that makes you due back here on the 19th of December at 6:30. Have a nice trip.
So, if the old boy doesn't make it, what becomes of the money?
If Mr. Mouse fails to pass the test, his entire inheritance reverts to the executor.
Why, Scrooge, that's you!
Exactly.
Goofy!
Hiya, Mickey. Just taking care of today's bills.
Put down that broom and pack your bags. We're going around the world in 80 days. Let's go!
What's the big hurry? We're not leaving for 80 days.
So Mickey and his goofy companion were off, traveling by boat from London to Paris, where they were to catch a train. Having barely made their connection, they took the train to Italy. Brindisi, Italy, to be exact.
Goofy, do you mind?
Oh, yeah, sorry.
From Brindisi, they crossed the Mediterranean Sea to Egypt, then crossed the Arabian Sea to Bombay. And all was right on schedule until...
Rotten luck. There's no way I can make it now.
Hey, Mickey, grab your bags. We can take this here pachyderm.
A wedding. Come on, we gotta keep moving. We're losing time.
Mickey? Gosh, she's beautiful.
I don't want to go through with this. I don't want to marry you.
What a shame. A beautiful young princess that looks kind of like you marrying somebody else.
Oh, well, let's go.
Wait.
Huh?
We can't go.
Why not?
We gotta save her.
Save her? I said save her.
Mickey?
Psst. Who are you?
A friend.
Mickey!
Old Mickey!
Come on!
Thank you for saving me. Where are we going?
Around the world in 52 days.
Did you hear, Scrooge? The old boy's reached Bombay.
Looks like you'll be handing over that inheritance after all.
Not necessarily, for I will make sure that Mr. Mickey Mouse's 80 days are numbered.
Right now, let's get some useful travel tips from Professor Ludwig von Drake.
Hello there. Today, we're going to prepare for the most dangerific, spine-melting, nerve-crunching part of traveling. The packing. We're going to calculate how to accommodate all your unmentionables. First, we open up the luggage. Second, measure the SR. That's space in there. Now multiply the SI with the SYWB, stuff you wanna bring. And to this the TF, the tushy force, which is how hard your bottom can sit on it. And from this, we're getting a number. That's the number of extra suitcases you're gonna need to carry all of that junk. Good luck! Looks like the professor picked up a stowaway over there. See you next time.
Now get going.
Yeah, you'll miss your boat. Maybe we should wait till the next act goes on. Who is it anyway?
The pink elephants.
Oh, no!
Pink elephants! Pink elephants!
Gosh, we are! Somebody has to intro the next cartoon! And now, here's the exciting conclusion to Around the World in 80 Days!
And so, Mickey Mouse with Goofy and Princess Minnie continued his trip around the world by crossing mainland China. During their voyage across the Pacific, Mickey found himself thinking less and less about money and more about Minnie. To make it across the Wild West, our traveling trio resorted to Goofy power.
Whoa, whoa.
The final leg from New York to London would take 9 days via steamship, arriving in the early morning of Sunday the 19th, just in time. That is, unless they were to have a run-in with one greedy duck.
You're gonna love London, and after I pay off all the bills, I'm gonna show you the best time money can buy. We'll have a fancy dinner and take in a show, maybe even go dancing.
It sounds so romantic.
It will be. I mean, it will be.
It's horrible. It's terrible. And it's awful, too.
Am I interrupting?
Aw, Goofy, what is it?
The coal. Somebody dumped all the coal off the boat.
Oh, nuts!
Well, we'll never make it on time.
Oh, we gotta make it. We just need to think of something else we can use as fuel.
Gee, the only other thing I can think of that can burn is wood. But where can we get wood in the middle of the ocean?
Bet you thought I was gonna fall.
The fancy dinner and the show and the dancing I promised you. You'll just have to go without me. Oh, Goofy. Looks like the orphanage can't afford to keep you around any longer. Here, I'm sure the pawn shop will give you a fair price for this.
Well, I can't take your watch.
And I don't want your money.
But I don't get it.
I'm your friend, Mickey. And that don't cost you a penny.
And I love you, not your money.
Gosh, really?
You bet.
Oh, you guys are just swell. Well, time to tell everybody the bad news. Say, do you hear bells?
I do.
And so do I.
But why are church bells ringing on Monday? Unless... we gained one whole day when we crossed the international dateline. That means it's one day earlier than we thought.
Looks like he's not going to make it.
He's not late yet, Scrooge.
Oh, yes, the old boy still has a chance.
5, 4, 3, 2.
Good show, old boy.
I knew you'd do it.
And so it came to pass that Mickey Mouse made the journey around the world in 80 days. And he and Minnie lived happily ever after.
Okay, Minnie, we got all we need for a vacation, and the show is practically over. Come on, let's go.
Goodbye, have fun.
Come on, Min.
Yeah, it's not like the place is going to catch on fire.
Hey, the place has caught on fire.
Ooh, the party is heating up just the way I like it.
She did it.
You booked 101 dragons?
But I love dragons.
Besides, we can handle it.
We better help.
Coming.
I'd say that act was all wet.
Yeah, yeah, everybody's a critic.
Well, the fire's out and the show must go on.
So now what are we gonna do?
You're going on vacation.
Yeah, we'll take care of the show.
I suppose it's okay, since the show's almost over anyway.
I'm not worrying him. They can handle it.
Everybody.
We're here to say forget all about that flood with this nice dry cartoon about fishing. Oops.
Nothing beats a day of fishing.
Something.
You don't say.
What happened?
Everything was fine until Goofy's chainsaw juggling act, or was it when Zeus and Chernabog played darts with those lightning bolts? So what we needed to tell you is
we can't handle it.
Running this club is exhausting. Now we need a vacation. See you in a month.
Well, at least we got a vacation.
And that vacation was courtesy of Monstro Cruise Lines. You'll have a whale of a good time, frolic on the famous blowhole, and enjoy the Blubber Buffet. Monstro Cruise Lines. Your vacation can't fail if you're in the belly of the whale.
Well, looks like we gotta rebuild, so I'll see you real soon.
Hi, everybody. It's me, Goofy. Did you know that the world's fastest dog is the Greyhound? Yep, some of them can run up to 41 miles an hour. Gosh, that's faster than I drive my car. Be sure not to say anything to Pluto, because he thinks he's the fastest dog around. I know, it'll be our secret. Goodbye now.